Hi, it's Kim Darwaza here, your Northern Virginia realtor, and I haven't been on in a while with a live video, so I wanted to take this time to answer a question that has come up a lot lately on my new buyer appointments. I also have people who a lot of people are going from a smaller house to a larger house right now or downsizing. So the top question I'm getting is, do I think that the market is getting close to the top again? And I don't think it's a different market today than back in 2005, 2006, when we had low inventory. We're in it still in a very extremely low inventory situation here. The differences between now and then is the houses that are turnkey now that everyone loves will get 3 to 5 offers. Back then they were getting 20. And I think some of the differences are that we don't have that whole subprime mortgage group of people because the lenders are still being much more cautious with lending money. So it used to be, we used to joke that if you had a pulse or could fog a mirror, you could get a loan, but that is not the case. They're still very, it's definitely loosened up since like a few years ago they were really, really tight with lending, but it's definitely loosened up, but there's still a lot more requirements. So just to give you, like, so what I'm seeing is too that back then the buyers would pretty much buy anything. And so today the turnkey houses, people are not as interested in making updates and things as they would back then. So your house still can sit on the market longer. People are more particular about things like room sizes for master bedroom, master bath, those kind of things that are important. And they will not buy the house for those reasons, where before people would just kind of jump at anything. So what I'm finding now too is a lot of houses are also selling before they even come on the market. I have sold several houses in the last 12 months before they even hit the MLS. And how people find them is I do advertising through Facebook, Instagram, those kind of things, yard signs. You used to be able to put stuff in MLS and is it coming soon, and it wouldn't count towards your days on market. Now I think we changed systems so it does, so people aren't doing that as much. But people will, like, for instance, I had a buyer actually sold her house before it was in the MLS, and I wound up finding her something on Zillow that was listed as coming soon. So I reach out to those other agents, and not everybody wants every Tom, Dick, and Harry to come parading through their house, because a lot of people are like, well, why wouldn't they put it in the MLS? And they could get multiple offers and they could get a higher amount of money. But not everybody wants that. They don't, or they're on a time schedule where they just want to go ahead and take the offer. I had one client who's like, if you can sell the house before it's on the market, that's great. I want to be homeless. It was really kind of funny. So anyway, so I don't really think we're at the top. I will say, like, in my neighborhood, at the peak, the highest person paid $600 for a townhouse, and now the highest price so far is $555. So we're not quite there yet. But some neighborhoods too are there, and it's here everything's driven by schools too. So houses. What I'm finding in the pyramid where I live, Oakton 700 to like 1.2, those houses can go in a weekend or a week. But if you go a little bit further out to Centerville, those houses will sit longer. So it still is very geographic related and school related. So even houses I found, like in my school pyramid where I live, that didn't have updates, they all still went over a weekend, and they were in the $800,000 to $900,000 range. So it's definitely depends on where you live, and also that's for a single family home. Usually condos are not as competitive as a single family home, and then townhouses depending upon what size and location. So those are just my thoughts of the day. If you have any questions about anything, or if you feel like you have additional things based on what I've said that you want to ask, feel free to leave me a comment or PM me, and I will be happy to get back to you. And thanks for watching.